Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can implement sales processes in Salesforce. If you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So now we are going to understand how we can create sales processes in Salesforce. So first of all, let me open sales application. So here it is. So I'm opening sales application. So here you will see one tab related to opportunities. So if I click on opportunity and open any record, so on opportunity record, you will see a pick list named as stage. And if I click on edit, so here you will see various values are available in stage pick list, right? So now our requirement is to create record types on opportunity object. So to create record types for opportunity object, we need to go to setup. So now we are moving to setup. So in object manager, I'm going to search for opportunity object. Here it is. Now I'm clicking on record types. So now I'm going to create a record type for opportunity. So we create record types so that we can control values of pick list. Like for one layout, we want separate pick list values. For another layout, we want separate pick list values. So basically we create record types for this purpose. We can also control layouts with record type, but right now we are discussing about pick list controlling. So we want to control stage pick list of opportunity object. So here you can see a message is written. So while you are going to create record type for opportunity object, you need to remember that opportunity record type must be associated with a sales process. You currently do not have any active sales process. You must create a sales process before creating the opportunity record type. So now you might be thinking what sales process is. So friends, whenever we want to control stage pick list of opportunity object, so that you cannot directly control it with record types. So you can control it with only sales processes. So basically use of sales process is to control stage pick list of opportunity object. So once you created sales processes for opportunity object stage pick list, then you can use those sales processes while creating record types, right? So now first we need to create sales processes. So I'm going to create two sales processes because we are going to use those two sales processes for creating two different record types. So here you can see new sales process we can create. So existing sales process, nothing is available. So master is by default available. So sales process name. So I am putting demo one. This is demo one sales process, right? I'm clicking on save. So as you click on save, you will see stage pick list values will be available automatically. So here you can read opportunity stages is available. Sales process name is demo one. Then here all the values are available. So I am removing some of the values. So I am removing value proposition. I am removing this. I am removing this. So, and this one also, right? So only six values are available for this demo one sales process. So now I am saving it. So this way I created one sales process. Now I'm going to create another one. So for this, I am using demo one as existing sales process so that I can modify that. So this is demo two sales process. right? So right now I'm giving demo, so right, that's why I'm using these names. If you want any specific name while working on any project or assignment, so you can do so. So this is the setting we did for demo one. So now for demo two, I am adding all these. So for demo two sales process, all stage picklist values will be available. So you can see total 10 values are available. And for demo one, we chose only 6. So now I'm clicking on save. So this way we created 2 sales processes, a demo one and demo two. And these are associated with opportunity stage picklist values. So now we can create record types for opportunity. So let me open this record again. So here you will see, if we click on edit, so all 10 values are available: prospecting, qualification, need analysis, value proposition, ID, decision makers, perception, proposal, negotiation, close won, and close lost, right? So now after creating record types, you will see one will be having all values and another will be having only 6 values. So again, I'm searching for opportunity, clicking on record type, creating new record type. So now you will see it is not throwing any warning, like we don't have any sales process. So it is asking for existing record type. So we don't have any existing record type. So label is opportunity demo one. So it will be its API name. Then now we need to choose sales process. So I'm choosing demo one, right? So our first record type will be opportunity demo one and name of sales process is demo one. So for demo one sales process, we selected only 6 values. So you will see those values. So this is opportunity demo one record type, right? And it will be active. So by default, it is selected because this is the first record type. So that's why it is active. We want it to available for all profiles. If you want to deselect any particular profile, so you can uncheck those checkboxes. So right now I am selecting all, clicking on next. Now it is asking for the page layout. So if you want different page layouts for different record types, so then you need to create different layouts as well. So right now I am selecting this opportunity layout, and I am selecting this opportunity layout for all the profiles, right? And I will be selecting this opportunity layout for both the record types as well, because right now I am demonstrating how we can create how we can control stage picklist. So I'm not focusing on the layout thing. I'm just focusing on the picklist control, and that is for stage picklist only. So now name will be opportunity demo two, sales process demo two. Then this is opportunity demo two record type. So this should be active, available for all the profiles. Page layout, I'm setting same. So all the fields will be available for both record types. Only we are controlling stage picklist. So now you can see we are controlling stage picklist with sales process, but rest of the picklist you can control with the record type. So for demo two record type, 3 fields are available as picklist that you can control. If we open demo one, so for demo one also 3 picklist will be available for editing. So friends, remember, whenever you create record types for opportunity object, so stage picklist is controlled by sales process and other picklists can be controlled through record types, right? So we are good till here. So we created 2 record types and 2 sales processes. Now I'm moving to opportunity tab. So I'm making a refresh. So I refreshed the org so that changes will be implemented. So we are on opportunity. Now I'm going to create new opportunity. So you will see two record types, opportunity demo one and opportunity demo two. So I'm selecting opportunity demo one first. So you will see stays pick list will be having only six values. So you can count, only six values are available here, right? So let's say its name is demo one, selecting close state, then I'm selecting stage and clicking on save. So this way I created demo one record. Now I am creating one more opportunity for demo two record type. So here you will see all 10 stage pick lists are available. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, all 10 values are available, because for opportunity demo two record type, we used demo two sales process and there we chose all stage pick lists, right? So this is demo two. Let's say close date is this, stage qualification and clicking on save. So this way I created two different records for two different record types, and these are controlled by sales process. There's a stage pick list is controlled by sales process, right? So I hope you understood how we can create sales process to control stage pick list of opportunity object. So whenever you are going to create record types or record types on opportunity object, so always remember to create sales process. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube. And you can follow my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.